I was watching some of the remarkable video presentations by David LaPointe, titled The Primer Fields, and noticing the shapes, the energy flows, magnetic flows, if you will, and the central column of light too, if you will. And it got me thinking about correspondences and the ritual space. If we turn now to go within the interior of a lodge room at the Sydney Masonic Centre, you have the double pillars. There are three of them, I believe, in this room from memory, and on three of the walls. And you have the triangular shape above the pillars, and within that there is a symbol on each within each of those, the three of them. The first one, by the way, would perhaps relate in part to the male. The second one, the level, would perhaps relate to the sun with the straight lines, and the third one would perhaps relate to the moon with the more feminine lines shown. Also, you would have a Freemason situated within the pillars also. I would suggest they sit in those regions of the room. In the centre of the room we have the star, as you would have noticed on the checkered floor, and the star, I would suggest, represents the column in the centre. Now, you could either have an altar here, I would suggest, for various rituals, or you would have the mage, the actual person, the magician there, the Masonic magician, in the centre. And you would have the column of light that in reality is perhaps seen clairvoyantly within the ritual space when somebody is perhaps raised within their chakras. Although this may not necessarily be the case also. But so if we go to a website called The Cracked Spine, it features the Lotus Temple in Yogaville in Virginia in the States. There are many interesting pictures there with the chakras, and there's so much to talk about. Within the temple, there's a magic circle with the globe there, which would be the world globe, but it's like a sort of spirit in the center of the magic circle, which I find very interesting. Many things to say within this temple, but for the purposes here, we have, if we have a look at this particular picture here, we have the same pillars with the triangular structure at the top. There are actually symbols within there too, and then you have the edifice there with the lines of light heading up and meeting the light from the central column in the center. Now, in a prior video, I talked about, well, I read from the book by Furs Morrish, The Ritual of Higher Magic, and it talked about energies from the ritual space being displaced out into the wider world. So we'll just go to that reading for a moment. The sight of a lodge at work, seen by those who claim to possess extended sight, is said to indicate that each member has his psychic part to play in forming a column to help in the building of the temple. And that this is literally true because the aura of each devoted member who aspires to become a true brother and Mason will be seen glowing like a column of light rising above the head and forming part of the psychic edifice within which the ritual is performed. This edifice is composed of the actual auric emanations and vibrations of the human and angelic beings present at a certain point in the ceremony. The spiritual powers generated within this edifice or temple may be spread abroad upon the surrounding world. That, at any rate, appears to have been its function in ancient Egypt in the lodges founded by the Brotherhood of Light. Now, getting back to the blog site, The Cracked Spine, if we just read from a paragraph here, we can read, The sixth chakra, or ajna, is represented by the circular clerestory of windows. The seventh or final chakra, sahasrara, is represented by the spire on top of the temple, radiating the energy out and into the world. So it's interesting that, well, I find it very interesting that the little sort of spire on top of the temple is the place where there is this, where in this case, the blog site is saying that the energy is radiated out into the world. And indeed, we can see that spire in many places. And I would suggest that it's also represented by the cross, for example, also the radiant cross on top of the church, for example, radiating out that energy into the wider world. In the case of the Masonic Lodge, I find it interesting that the G is situated up near the ceiling in some rooms. Now, the G may be symbolic of this region of radiating energy out into the wider world. It's just a thought for now.